is on, and that means a higher risk for dehydration. And today we asked the doctor about summer heat and lightheadedness. Dr. Hunt Brantley at Brigham Baptist Medical Center joining us live virtually FaceTime to explain what causes that woozy feeling from dehydration to serious medical conditions. How you doing, Doc?
I'm doing great, thanks.
Okay, so when we're talking about dehydration, what exactly is dizziness when it comes into that?
Right, so, you know, dizziness kind of sometimes can mean several different things to different people, so I think it's very important to really describe what you mean by when you say you feel dizzy. Really kind of narrows down to two different problems. One is lightheadedness, which is more of a feeling like you're going to faint or pass out, but you don't really feel like your surroundings are moving. Sometimes it can get worse when you're standing up, whereas vertigo is a separate issue, and it feels more like the room is spinning around you. You may feel off balance, falling, tilting. And so, you know, these are the two different types of reasons people will feel, you know, what we call dizzy a lot of times during the summer.
Yeah. So what causes vertigo or lightheadedness?
Right. So vertigo really is probably one of the less common things I see. Lightheadedness is more common during the summer and from a cardiologist's perspective. But usually vertigo implies that there's a kind of a central inner process, usually an inner ear problem, which we call benign positional vertigo. Someone may have had an injury to their ear or their head, or even migraine headaches sometimes cause vertigo. And so that's a completely different problem than lightheadedness. So lightheadedness, as we know, is very common. Anybody can have lightheadedness from time to time. That's not really a sign of a serious problem, but it can become an issue when it becomes recurrent and people begin to develop severe symptoms with it. And so a lot of times you'll feel faint, weak, unsteady on your feet, maybe a disoriented feeling of floating or swimming. Sometimes you can get nauseated, flushed, or sweating feeling. And then as far as causes go to lightheadedness, you know, typically one of the most common reasons is something called orthostatic hypotension, and that's where people stand up and too suddenly, maybe from the bed or working outside, squatting down in the garden or something, get very lightheaded, their blood pressure drops. And these are triggered by things such as, you know, fevers or illnesses. Medications actually that we take can cause orthostatic hypotension. So sometimes it can actually be a side effect. And then the other issues of lightheadedness from a cardiologist perspective are the things like abnormal heart rhythms, valvular heart disease. Maybe they're anemic, and then even anxiety and stress, which lead to hyperventilation, can cause lightheadedness.
Yeah, so with about 30 seconds to go, what type of treatments are out there when you're suffering these things?
Absolutely. So we really, you know, we're going to try to identify the etiology. Obviously, if it's medications, we're going to eliminate that medicine. But for the most, it's conservative, trying to increase water hydration during the day, potentially wearing compression stockings. Some people need to increase salt in their diet, actually.